from Radio Deutsche Welle in Cologne, Melody Time. We invite you to join us for 30 minutes of light classical music. Hello there, I'm Maurice O'Brien de Clare. Welcome to this edition of Melody Time. I'd like to begin today's program with a musical tribute written over 100 years ago to a humble non-alcoholic drink. I'm talking about water, mineral water to be precise, which has made a small town in West Bohemia, today's Czech Republic, world famous. During the last century, the Karlovy Vary, or in German, Karlsbad Spa, developed into one of the most popular and fashionable health resorts for Europe's wealthy and titled. Listen now to this waltz entitled Karlsbader Sprudelgeister, roughly translated Karlsbader Water Spirits. It was written by Ferdinand Sabatil and is played now by the Cologne Radio Orchestra, conducted by Heinz Gieser.
Thank you.
Karlsbader Sprudelgeister Waltz by Ferdinand Sabatil. The sulfur springs at Karlsbad were and still are valued for treating digestive disorders. Since the Middle Ages, this small town on the River Teppler has been patronized by rulers, princes, noblemen, diplomats, artists, bankers, and ecclesiastics. The sick came hoping to be cured of their ailments. For the healthy, Karlsbad was a chic resort to see and, more important, to be seen. Frequent guests of the spa included the composers Beethoven, Chopin, Brahms, and Wagner, the poets and writers Goethe, Schiller, and Pushkin, and the great Russian Tsar, Peter the Great. Of course, these illustrious guests also expected to be entertained. Now, the soothing effect of music has been known for centuries, and from about 1800, a small orchestra was sometimes hired to entertain the Karlsbad spa guests as they took the waters. These public concerts became so popular that it was decided in 1834 to establish a permanent municipal spa orchestra. Its first conductor, Josef Labitsky, was immensely successful. Known throughout Europe as the Bohemian Waltz King, Labitsky not only composed numerous delightful melodies for dance and entertainment, he also succeeded in putting, as it were, his spa orchestra on the musical map. When he stepped down in 1864, the Karlsbad Orchestra was regularly performing symphonies and oratorios of the very highest quality. Luckily, his son August was able to continue with the good work, and when he retired in 1903, the Karlsbad Orchestra had been in the very competent hands of the Libitskys for 70 years. This resulted in a remarkable continuity and increasing artistic quality and, of course, popularity. In 1951, the one-time spa orchestra became officially the Karlsbad Symphony Orchestra. Today, that symphony orchestra still follows the Libitsky tradition of playing all types of music, classic, sacred, popular, and, of course, modern. Great singers, like great orchestras, are also not limited in their repertoire. For them, there's no difference between serious and popular music. Either music is good or bad. The world-famous soprano Elisabeth Schwarzkopf demonstrates this in the following aria from an operetta written by Karl Zeller entitled Der Obersteiger, or The Foreman. Sei nicht böse, roughly, don't be cross with me.
Rein.
Sei nicht böse, from the operetta Der Obersteiger by Carl Zeller. Elisabeth Schwarzkopf was accompanied by the Philharmonia Orchestra London, conducted by Otto Ackermann. At the beginning of the program, I spoke of the famous Bohemian Carlsbad Spa and some of its illustrious visitors. I mentioned the Russian Tsar Peter the Great, about which much has been written, though not all of it accurate. The composer Albert Lortzing wrote a very popular opera involving Peter the Great, one of Russia's most famous rulers. The plot, however, of Tsar and Carpenter must be taken with a grain of salt. True, he did modernize Russia and turned it into a strong naval power. True, he did travel to the Netherlands to study the skills of the famous Dutch shipbuilders. But he did not, as the opera would have us believe, live for weeks on end under an assumed name, causing all sorts of amusing misunderstandings. But this is musical theatre, and as my grandmother used to say, everything is allowed as long as it's sung. I'd like you to listen now to one of the most famous melodies from this great opera. It's called the Holzschuh-Tanz, or Wooden Shoe Dance, and believe it or not, wooden clogs are still worn in most parts of Holland today. Whether people still actually dance in them is another matter. Thank you. The Holzschuh-Tanz from the opera Czar and Carpenter by Albert Lortzing. The Southwest German Radio Orchestra was conducted by Emmerich Smoller. Still on the subject of European rulers, the operetta Die Dubarry by Karl Müllerker is set during the reign of King Louis XV of France. The Dubarry is none other than the beautiful and clever courtesan and mistress of the king, Madame Dubarry. As in Czar and Carpenter, here too fiction takes over from historical fact. The real Madame Dubarry was literally the power behind the throne, the secret queen of France. For 6 years, she was mistress to the king, and in that time greatly influenced the French monarch in matters political. But then he died, and she was forced to live in a convent. Almost 20 years later, revolutionaries dragged her from her place of exile and beheaded her on the guillotine in Paris. Well, obviously not the sort of stuff that operettas are made of. In Müllerker's Die Dubarry, we have the romantic story of how the fair lady has to make a choice between the king and the handsome René. Of course, the king wins. But the lovers meet one last time and remember their happy times together.
Stirbt sie nicht, wenn Herz vertraut zum Herzen spricht, erwecke sie nach langer Pein aus dunkler Nacht zu hellem Sein.
Oh, wenn ich doch den Weg zurück in neue Liebe, neues Glück, wie könnte alles herrlich sein, bis ich gewiss bin wie.
Ich denk zurück an jene Zeit. I look back to that certain time. That duet was from the operetta Die Dubarry by Karl Müllerker. You heard Erika Kurt and Horst Wilhelm, accompanied by the Berlin Symphonica, conducted by Frank Fox. I'd like to conclude today's program with an excerpt from a work by one of Germany's most famous and certainly most flamboyant composers, Georg Friedrich Händel. Actually, I should say English composer, because after emigrating to England and becoming an English subject, he now called himself George Frederick Handel. Here's the third part of his fireworks music. The Slovakian Philharmonic Orchestra is conducted by Oliver Donani.
Thank you.
part of the fireworks music by George Frederick Handel, ending this edition of Melody Time. The program, which was produced by Stephanie Giesen with sound engineer Winfried Neumann, came to you from Radio Deutsche Welle in Cologne, Germany. This has been Maurice O'Brien de Clare, wishing you all the very best, and do take care, won't you? Bye now. Thank you.